Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to the Walnut School production of The Little Mermaid, presented by the Missoula Children's Theater and featuring the young actors of Rock Springs. Before we begin our show, we have a very special treat. Professor Ermengarde Thumperdumper, the world's leading authority on sea creatures, past and present, will honor us with a short lecture, which I'm sure will make our production a truly educational experience. Professor Thumperdumper, if you please.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, and thank you once again. I am delighted to be here in Rock Springs, Wyoming, a state so very far from the sea. Oh, but the sea need never really be far from our hearts, thanks to my brand new traveling aquatic exhibit from the world-renowned Thumperdumper Aquarium. Now, as I unveil our fish tank on wheels, let attention be paid. For a careful eye will observe creatures of all shapes, sizes, and colors as well. Ooh la la. Like an electric eel. Where does he plug in? And a stingray? Too friendly to sting. Oh, schools of fish study undersea music while perched at their desk. Oh, listen! They're learning their scales.
La 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 la.
Oh, sardines nap soundly in their comfortable cans, confident that in our tank dwell only the safest and cutest and cuddliest of creatures. No, nothing scary. Nothing at all.
Yum, 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 yum.
Well, enough of that. I would like at this time to welcome the Rock Springs chapter of the Sea Scouts of Wyoming. These young people share my fascination with the sea and will assist me in telling our tale. Let's give them a warm round of applause. Of the deep began in my teenage years. I would swim for hours.
Huh?
I would sit for hours.
Oh.
My toes dangling over the icy Atlantic. Oh, at the end of an abandoned wharf in my hometown, the tiny seaside village of Cape Elizabeth, Maine. Oh, thoroughly consumed by an insatiable curiosity for all things oceanic, I would spread my yearning youthful arms over the green and glassy surf and, you guessed it, burst into song. Maestro, if you please. I wonder what's under the sea. What features, what creatures, what mystery. What could I uncover? What would I discover? What's waiting down under for me? Once I got a notion to go to the ocean to see things that I had never seen. So from Alabama, I rented a yellow and lavender striped submarine.
I wonder what's under the sea? What's waiting down under?
Waiting down under for me. portholes of my tiny aging submersible, and soon was consumed by a world of shape and color and life that was beyond even the furthermost crannies and cubbyholes of my imagination. A goldfish, a bluefish, and one that was pink! An octopus writing a poem in ink. A friendly old turtle who gave me a wink, all smiling down under at me. A playful young dolphin with thumb in his face. A catfish, a dogfish, cut up in a chase, but nothing resembling my own human race was smiling down under at me.
I wonder what's under the sea. What features?
First, hello to last, good Ah, well, they'll be along shortly.
Say, thanks for trying, Gil. You're always so helpful. Such a good neighbor. The girls and I are grateful that the good and gracious Gil is our friendly mer boy next door.
As Esther the oyster would say, ah, shucks.
And a sense of humor, too. Now, where are your little friends?
Theo, Amelia, Ophelia, Celia, oh, girls.
Dearest, darling, and daughters of mine, swim along home in some summer time. Late as usual, what's a mermaid to do? Oh, well, hello, neighbor.
Good evening, Mrs. Mermaid.
Hey, Miss Merman.
What's shaking, Miss Merman?
Hello, it's
Miss Merman. How are you tonight?
I'm good.
Well, pretending to see my girls in your travels.
Not me, Mrs. Merman.
Sorry, Mrs. Merman. Not this thing
today. I don't think so.
Not tonight.
Sorry, I'm going looking.
We won't look for sure.
This silly girl.
They're always late.
I haven't seen them.
No way.
Oh, hey, look, Gil. Here come our other neighbors. The starfish and a handsome herd of happy horses.
Of the sea variety, of course.
Well, of course. Welcome, neighbors. Matter of fact,
here comes Celia!
Well, that's my Celia.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow is my birthday.
Yeah.
in a pod?
15, Mother.
Woo, 15, so soon? And Delia, my oldest, tomorrow you shall be...
Sweet 16 and never been...
Of course not! There's plenty of time for that when you're 30, 40. But tomorrow, Delia visits the world above. Oh, how I envy you, my dear. I remember my visit as though it was yesterday, even though it was nearly 20 years ago. How quickly time goes by. The shifting sands go drifting by, the sands of time that make time fly. Would you like to hear about my visit?
Yes!
All right, if you insist. I swiftly swam to the salty surface of the Sassafras Sea.
Mom, please!
Sorry. Once there, I quickly made my way to the rocky ledge, which was just as my mother had described to me, and it soon became apparent I had arrived on a very special day.
Behind you by any chance?
La 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 la.
Oh, hello.
Well, gotta swim.
Well, goodbye! All eager to hear about your adventures. But first, we must celebrate a very special day for all my little mermaids with a song!
Here's a happy birthday to you. Here's a happy birthday to you. Today's the day to swim and play. And that is why we're here to say happy birthday to you.
Do you need a hug? How about a laugh to lift your spirits?
we're walking back to the castle to celebrate the big day.
Walking? What is walking? Can you do it while you sing?
Well, it's sort of like swimming, except for there's no water, and they have these strange fins called legs. Mm-hmm.
Oh, and Celia?
Something called dancing.
Dancing? Do you hear? They must have music!
Music? A song for me to sing?
La 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 la.
All right, be patient, girls, and you too, Gil. In just a year, the twins will turn 16 and pay their visit to the world above. But for now, off to the kitchen for a bite of my kelp cake. It's fresh from the oven and smells simply. For sure. And speaking of sand, the shifting sands go drifting by, the sands of time that make time fly. Another year has passed, and this time Amelia and Ophelia will tell us all about their journey to the world above. Well, that is, if they ever get home.
Our way.
Oh, what can we do to save the day?
Let's
subjects. History at school was a smash too. This year was about sports. All of the coaches asked me to be on their team, but I said, please, there are more athletes than me that are better.
But if you had a chess team, I'd like to try out for that.
And where are you going?
My name more.
Hello?
Well, we just thought, you know, it was a good day for wrestling,
wandering, and building.
And besides, it's Friday. We always
wrestle, wander, and village
on Friday.
Great way to end the week, don't you think?
Uh-huh, an idea. The only problem, it's Saturday, sir.
Saturday? It's Saturday?
Did you hear that?
Days and days to swim and play, and that is why we're here to say, hap, hap,
flounders.
See you soon, Celia.
We'll be here waiting when you return.
I'll be here waiting when you return.
Okay, goodbye, everyone. I'll see you when I come home later this afternoon. Now let me see. Mother said to swim to the surface and find the rocky ledge.
The job is simple. Find the perfect bride for our oh-so-eligible leading man, the prince. But brace yourself, ladies, because here he comes, our own leading man, the tamer of dragons. Let's give it up for the royal prince! Welcome, your coolness. Now, I bring you two finalists in the race to be your bride. The first contestant you really must see, the loveliest maiden in all of the land.
My fans are fantastic, you'll count at least three. My beauty is flawless, as you can see. My hair is so silky, my skin's like a pearl. Let's face it, Prince Perfect, I'm the perfect girl!
Beauty skin only D. Luckily, I have thick skin.
All right. Now, this is the last of the lot. And simply put, she's ravishingly rich.
Can I be your princess? Well, how about it, Sunny? What I'm lacking in beauty, I make up in money.
Hey! You look familiar! Esmeralda, is that you?
I've waited so long to marry my prince. Let's get on with it, Sunny.
Money is good, don't get me wrong, but I'm looking for a better song. That's it!
I've got it, your hipness. What you want is fun. A wife you can sing with.
Oh, yes!
But most of all, dance.
Oh, no!
I have a royal brainstorm. I'm thinking light bulb.
Ding!
Right over my head. Yeah. The new contestant will dance with the prince.
Hooray!
And the very best dancer will be his new bride.
Hooray!
Oh, no! Do you really think that will work?
Oh, yes, of course. Now let's get together an hour after brunch. You must now go practice your dance steps.
I'm on my way. Da-da-da-da-da. Hey! Da-da-da-da-da.
There he goes, and aren't we proud? Now, we better go practice our dance moves.
I must leave too. I must get back to the world below. Delia and Amelia and Ophelia were right. The prince is so perfect. And he loves to sing and dance. If only I had legs, I could dance, and win the contest and become the prince's bride. What a thought.
What a thought.
Oh, hi, Gil.
Hi, Celia. Are you happy to be home?
Happy? I'll never be happy ever again. Not without legs to dance with the prince.
So you need legs to win the prince's hand, and that will make you happy?
Oh, yes, so happy. But it will never happen.
Don't count your chickens out of the sea before they hatch, because we got one neighbor who can give you legs. She inherited her powers from her grandmother, the sea witch. And now, unfortunately, she got the power, but not the temper. And now she's working at the Seahorse Corral to become a seahorse, the movie.
Star!
You must mean
the starfish!
Come on, she's probably singing songs at the Seahorse Corral.
Oh, thank you so much for your help, Gil. You're smart and kind and sort of cute.
Really?
Oh, forget about that part. Let's just go find the starfish! Yahoo!
Yahoo! That's right, Kangaroos, it's me, your favorite singing starfish. Now you get to sing at the Oyster Bar, but that place is a dive.
I can't fathom why anybody would go there.
I told the owner that place gave me a hat on. He made me sing corny old tunes like Clam every now and then. You walrus hurt the one you love, and big gulls don't coy. I told him those songs had no soul, but he said, abalone.
What a crab.
He must have been really steamed. Good one, Celia.
So I decided I want to sing movies, not scary movies like Jurassic Park or The Godfather. No siree, I'm talking about cowboy movies. Yahoo! And I'm going to share with you what I really love, a good old country town. Da-da-da-da, who are you?
I'm a country tuna.
I said country tune, not country tuna.
So get lost, Charlie!
Aww. Sorry, Charlie.
Aww. I need a pack of ponies to help sing the song just right.
Pleasure!
First we learn to count with 1, 2, 3. have to try.
Come on, let's have a big fish fry.
Hooray!
Ah! Yum, yum, yum.
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 I like any kind of fish. Fish, small fish, shellfish, any kind of fish.
Come on, Sarah, come on!
Wait, I can't swim fast enough with this silly leg!
Yes, Sarah!
So then, the starfish reversed the charm by saying the same words that gave her legs backwards! Okay, not really. What really happened went a little bit more like this.
First, I wave my arms like this. Then, I spin three times to the right. One, two, three. Then one time to the left. Stand on one foot and say, abracadabra and fishity foo. How about a cup of legs? Let's lose the legs. It's a fish tail for you.
All right, come with me out of the cold blue waters of your imagination. Up out of the last great unexplored neighborhood on all of planet Earth. Mermaids, just a story. Impossible. Gil and Celia, I wish they were real. Oh, I really do. But of course, they can't be.
Oh, Professor!
What with the fish?
It doesn't quite fit in.
What's the meaning of this? Is this just another fish tail?
It can't be real!
I don't believe it!
Those aren't legs! That's a fin, all right!
Something's fishy, I'll say.
What should we do?
I'll pay no attention to the fish tail beneath my coat!
Professor, you're a mermaid!
Oh, I've been caught! Like a fish. Oh, so now you know. Everything I've been telling you is true. Every last scale and tail.
We love your story, but how does it end?
Ah, well, it ends a little bit like this.
So why bow?
traveled all the way to another world, a world where the grass is always greener. And what did you learn?
I learned that everything and everyone that I've always wanted is right here. And what reminded me of the prince, what I liked about the prince reminded me of Gil, my best friend. And oh, Mom, there's no place like home.
Ha! That sounds familiar. Oh, what a perfect ending!
It's perfect, it's perfect. The only bird is perfect. A perfect holiday in every way. It's perfect.
Thank you.